guys, welcome to the unboxing and first boot of the Realme C3. Now, what is interesting about this device is 6.5 inch huge screen, and besides that, Helio G70 AI processor. That's what is interesting in this mobile, because I think it performs really well for the price we are paying. Base variant 3GB 30GB costs you like 7000 rupees, 4GB 64GB version costs you 8000 Indian rupees. Another interesting thing is it supports reverse charging, and it has two dedicated slot for SIM and one dedicated slot for micro SD, which is 256GB up to that expandable. 12 megapixel AI dual camera, of course, and 5000 milliampere battery. So in this video, we will unbox this one as well as first boot the device. Like, if you have bought this Realme C3 and you don't know how to set up this for the first time, so this video should help you. In the next video, I'm going to make review and a lot of other interesting videos on this budget device, Realme C3. Pretty nice packaging. Welcome to the Realme family. So as always, nice packaging. So I think there's protective cover. Nope, there are some manual instructions and Realme quick guide as usual. And moving on, the phone here weighs quite a bit. It's hefty because of the 5000 milliampere hour. So there is a wall charger, of course, charging adapter. I think, is it a micro USB or USB-C type? Okay, so it is a micro USB. And yeah, pretty much that's it inside the box. Here's the mobile itself. So we will first boot this one. This is a blue color that I bought. So very nice packaging for the budget phone. Like, if you are buying Samsung phone, you will know how the package difference is between this one and that one. So shiny blue, which I really like. So here's the blue, like different effects you get. It's plasticky. Nothing special here, but still the phone looks really, really special as you are seeing. So AI dual camera, as you are seeing, there is 3.5 mm headphone jack, micro USB, speaker, microphone, and here's the front camera over there. And on the left side, you get volume up and down, micro SD card slot as well as SIM slot. And here's the power button. Slightly, there is wedge to this camera. Here's camera setup. And I'm quite surprised that there is no case for the phone itself. Alright guys, let's first boot this one. Ta-da! So here's your look at Realme powered by Android. This has the latest Realme operating system, which is kind of nice. And the camera itself supports Realme's Chroma Boost, one of the favorite for street photography. Like, if you are doing a lot of street stuff, pictures, then this camera will really help you take nice photos. So Realme UI seamless fun is what they call. 6.5 inch HD screen, sorry, HD plus, which means a bigger resolution, better resolution as compared to other phone in market for this pricing. As always, Realme prices this very competitively, and as you are already seeing, select language. You can select the interface language itself right over here. So for now, I'm just selecting the default as English US. And I can actually, you just tap on I agree to the user agreement. You don't have to tap like improve their service program and all. You don't have to opt for that. Just tap on that and next. Now here's the time to connect to the Wi-Fi. So if you have got home Wi-Fi network, just connect it. Otherwise, you can skip here without connecting to the internet. So I have the Wi-Fi here. I'll just connect and be right back. So after connecting to the internet, this is the screen you'll see. Wi-Fi assistant. You don't have to switch this one. Just tap on next. So it's checking for the updates. Just wait for a few seconds to boot up. And there you can see the battery remaining. I think only about 30% is remaining. It's connected to Wi-Fi. And copy apps and data. If you have got other apps and data in another phone, you can just copy over here. Otherwise, say don't copy. We are booting this one fresh, right? So this is the fresh new device. So here's the Google sign in. If you have got Google account, just go ahead and sign in. Use your email and password. If you don't have Gmail account, then you can just tap on create account if you are connected to the internet. Otherwise, you can straight away skip. So if you just tap skip, you'll just move to the further screen without having to sign this one. But if you want to use applications, you will need this Gmail account. So I'll just go ahead and sign in and be right back. All right, so this is the screen you'll see. Backup to Google Drive. Like, if you want to store your photos, passwords, as well as some other stuff to the Google account, you can always stick this one. Otherwise, just skip. And there's also use location. For now, we will just disable it. You don't have to use this. Like, whenever you want, you can just go ahead and manually turn on that. So send usage data, just opt out of this. These just consume battery, you don't need to enable all that, and then tap on accept. So your assistant will be right with you. Google Assistant setting up. The phone itself is like mix of teal as well as blue color, so it's really nice in person if you see. So check out what's trending, just set up Google Assistant, next, we will scroll through. If you want to set up, you can set up, otherwise just tap on skip. We'll just skip. So set lock screen password, just go to settings here, you can just type the password, or if you tap on other encryption method, here you will see pattern code, right? So here you can set up the pattern. For now we are just setting this phone up without any pattern, so I'll just go ahead and tap on later, and here I'll just tap later. So auto update overnight, okay. So if you have internet and at night, if you automatically want this one to update, if there is any software update, just enable that. Otherwise you can always disable this. Home screen icons default, as well as material style, pebble style, custom art plus icon, you can just agree and change it for yourself, which is really nice. As you can see, you can customize the home screen here, like icons, how the style you want it to be. So I'll just use this one. This looks sweet, right? So icon size and all, I'll just go ahead and apply this one. So auto update overnight and home screen icons, we have set this up. Import data later, app market not right now, we will just skip this one for now. Boom, there you go. Welcome Realme UI, get started. So this is the first screen you will see when you first boot the Realme C3. Ta-da! How beautiful is this new Realme OS? Very simplistic icons, and the interface itself feels pretty fluid. Just we will quickly move to settings, which is located here. I'll just scroll this one. So settings, about phone, where is it? About phone, Realme C3 device name, 3GB, 32GB variant, which costs you around 7,000 Indian rupees. So out of 32GB, 19.6GB is available device storage. So pretty neatly laid out, as you can see, very nice design. If I just tap on here, tap and hold, you have wallpaper, effects, settings, widgets, which we will look into later in another videos. This was just a video on showing you the first boot, as well as little camera thing. We will just go ahead and see how the camera interface is. No lag whatsoever, first impressions, which is really nice, because for this price usually you get phones with very laggy interface, but that's not the case here. 1x, 2x and 4x zoom, which is nice. Photo, video, portrait, HDR, chroma boost, you have the beauty mode here. We will jump to video. Okay, so photo. Yeah, I'll also cover separate video on camera settings, so make sure you are tuned to this channel. Alright guys, this was just a brief video on unboxing as well as first booting the Realme C3. The next video will be about reviewing this one, or we will look at the features that it has to offer. Till then, don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you are new. Hit that like button and share it with your friends. As always, I will see you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye-bye.